You're now listening to Our Two Cents FYC Show with Jose and Tinsley Brooks on Jammin' 107 WJAM, music that makes you jam.
We're back on the air, and I'm virtually floating on air, feeling energetic, fresh off that birthday sex. That's that extra special loving that your long-term partner has to put on you because it's the day that the universe blessed us with you.
Well, thanks. I appreciate that.
So all the taboos and reservations go out the door, or at least they should. In our house, we usually allow birthday powers, if you will, to run all week long.
Sometimes with him, all month long.
Whatever you can work out. You need all the breaks you can get.
Right. He looks for that birthday breakfast all week. Another birthday dinner.
And sometimes birthday gifts, a little birthday
gifts.
A little birthday gift throughout the month. That's important, all right, in maintaining a healthy relationship. Let's pause and go back a second, because last session, if you will, we had a question on the table that we raised. Is there a difference between how men and women communicate? You likely know by now that, yes, there is in our basic language. But you may be surprised that even in our nonverbal cues, there's a wide variance. In the home and in the office scenarios we created last time, most men are definitive. Their body language matches their head nods, right? They were signaling with the nod up and down, yes, I agree. I agree with you 100%. I'm totally on board. I'm with you.
And women, on the other hand, are nurturing and courteous. All they mean with a head nod is, I know where you're coming from. But a lot of men think in the back of their mind, too, that they just want to fix things. But they do not necessarily agree with you the slightest bit. And the fact that they could absolutely disagree with the statement you just uttered, and will often look for a moment to discuss their reservations in private.
There you go. So looks can be deceiving. You may not, probably in all likelihood, coming out of that house or room in the office, you do not have a consensus. The men almost will totally be on board, but the women may have some reservations. So watch for that.
And you might need to discuss more and communicate more.
Welcome to our second episode of Our Two Cents FYC for your consideration.
The show is about the couples aiming at long-term marriages.
I can't even say that word. I guess I need to lighten up on it a little bit. Long-term marriages and or relationships.
Right. And so please consider us as your relationship enthusiasts.
Right.
In our last episode, we exposed ourselves to you, and it was our 40-year marriage that mainly qualified us for this, to be enthusiasts. All of us, and kind of us, apart from most couples you may encounter.
We're kind of a rarity. Usually in the community, I don't want to self-identify as to the black community, because I think marriage is sometimes, goes across all cultures, right, the tendencies for marriage. I think the national average for divorce is 7 years, and
right.
Then they get remarried, and that one is even shorter than the second one. We'll
exactly.
go into some of that, too, as we go on in the episodes. So we think we're a rarity, right, that you may not have encountered yet in your circles.
So
Lance, in telling you about us and our relationship, let's consider that as foreplay, gentle foreplay. And we believe that now we got to bring the heat. So let's start.
So let's start, okay? Let's start with Valentine's Day.
Right.
Okay?
That just passed. And
Valentine's Day just passed.
And I was interested. In fact, I ran across this study. CNN revealed a study that cited 85% of men and women say sex is an important part of Valentine's Day. That was really interesting to me.
Okay, so the interesting part about that is that most people believe that sex Valentine's Day. And so the outcome would be sex after Valentine's Day.
Right.
So your gift would be part of sex.
There you go. Now, that's new information to me because I always knew and suspected that Valentine's Day is the bestowal, if you will, of gifts and compliments to maintain the relationship, right? But I never knew that after that. So I've been doing this all wrong for the last dozen years. I should be entitled.
We've been okay.
I should be entitled to some recompenses.
But a lot of men feel like, okay, if I'm giving you gifts, I'm giving you this
dinner.
Then I get
you
some sex later on. Okay.
And apparently, about 85% of men and women out there, you know, agree with that.
Right.
So our subject today is how to spice up your relationship. So thus far, let's reflect a little bit on our last conversation. Thus far, they've been lucky, Tim.
Right.
They
right.
found that one person
right.
in 285,000
mm-hmm.
that compliments them.
And we've been lucky at that because I found him, he found me.
There you go.
Okay.
So since sex in a relationship is so important, you don't want to take it for granted. You want to avoid some kind of scheduling event to a large extent and always be, you know, kind of ready and or always be trying something new and kind of innovative to spice it up in the bedroom.
So, you know, even if you got to sit back and think, okay, what can I do that's new with this man, okay, and keep him interested in the sex, keep him interested in me.
Besides what you might call the nationwide call for proper dieting and exercise, there are other things you can do in the bedroom to kind of spice that up. Because let's face it, there's a lot more involved and a lot more things you can try other than the standard missionary
position.
Hello. Maybe need to say that.
Right, in unison, all right.
So first, I mean, and we'll just talk back and forth, and there's no exact order. But you take these, you know, if you like it, hey, explore with it. If you don't, hey, move on.
Right.
First of all, some couples get into the habit during intercourse of talking dirty.
Dirty.
Right. Either during that moment or to each other. So if that's a turn on for you, hey, you know, I'm a cusser from way back. Dirty talk shouldn't be a problem for me.
It's not a problem for him. Remember the last time I told you he was a sailor.
There you go.
Okay, he's got that sailor mouth. So it's okay.
It comes honest.
All right. So women, you need to think about other things that you need to do, too. You might want to buy some sexy lingerie. You know, a lot of women go to Victoria's Secret. All right?
Hello.
And if you don't have the money to go to Victoria's Secret, believe me, there's other places that have some sexy lingerie.
Right. So basically, you're telling them they should toss those granny panties.
Oh, yes. Toss those granny panties. I got rid of mine a long time ago. Okay? Even if you got to split them in half,
you're going to make
some hip huggers with some granny panties.
And men should let go of those drawers, old-fashioned drawers?
Men just have to let go and just let them off. That's it with men. Women is a different thing, okay? You got to look sexy, all right?
Speaking of sexy, what about the house? Would you say that there's anything taboo as far as rooms in the house?
There's nothing taboo in the house. And believe me, you know, the house is your house.
There you go.
The bedroom is your bedroom.
There you go. Your kitchen table, your garage,
right.
Your closet, and or your secret place.
Right. Oh, yeah. That secret place. Nobody knows about that secret place, right, Jose?
Other than the couples themselves.
Right.
They don't
have
to tell us.
They don't have to tell us. You don't have to tell anybody about your secret place, okay?
In fact, talking about sex and spicing up the relationship, there used to be an old quality adage, right, in that field that said there's no bigger room in the house than the room for improvement. So,
right. Hey,
always look forward to, hey, what can I do, what can I say, what can we get involved in to spice
mm-hmm.
this thing up?
Right.
One of the things might be role play. Right?
Role play is really good, okay?
You might have a leftover Halloween costume.
Something that you can make yourself. You know, years ago, all right, when mama and daddy didn't have enough money to go out there and buy you a Halloween costume, you made it yourself, okay?
Yeah.
So there's ways that you can get out there and make you some really nice costumes.
So imagine this, fellas, right? You come home and the missus is dressed in a maid outfit with your favorite meal cooked for you. You maybe only got, or let's say, the wife might come home and the man is...
Oh, yeah, the man is dressed in some Speedos, all right? Some men don't like the Speedo because they often tight and everything else. But if the Speedo is okay, that's fine. Okay? She opens the door and finds you in the Speedo and everything else, and guess what?
You flipped the script. You got a full meal, her favorite meal, cooked
right.
for her, right? Her favorite, and it don't have to be flashy or fancy. It could be cereal, her favorite
mm-hmm.
cereal, or pizza. But the house is clean top to bottom.
Right.
You go to the bedroom, and you kind of clean that up and outfit it that to a small extent, make it look like a five-star hotel and spa.
And the man, you look at the man, and he's in his Speedos, and he's got his food cooked for you. The house is clean. Hey, guess what? You don't have to do anything but please him.
There you go. Speaking of pleasing, let's say that you're involved in the act itself, right? One of the things you might practice, in fact, I probably need some practice on this, right? Remember you told me early in the marriage, things like slow down.
Right.
What race am I going to?
Right.
Because you're right there.
I'm right here. I'm not going anywhere.
I was rushing. But more about that later. What you can do, ladies and gentlemen out there, is try to delay that orgasm for as long as possible. Take each other to the very edge and keep them there on that plateau for as long as possible. Let's reflect back.
Works out good.
Back on my inadequacy, because we were married in 1973, but it was a short year later, 74, I discovered, I was an inadequate lover. Now tell them what that means, what that term means.
So the inadequate lover is when, you take a short period of time and don't please the other one. Okay, when one is not sensitive to the other,
needs. Right.
Okay.
I was too much of a, what you might call a wham, bam, and now I need a nap, ma'am. So,
thank you, ma'am. I need a nap, ma'am.
Right.
Okay.
Chesley wasn't thoroughly satisfied.
No.
So we responded to that. We talked like we've been telling y'all. We talked it out because it's a very sensitive issue, but you got
to
get it out the way.
And
so
you got to
put it on the table. Yeah, you got to communicate. And now, you can, during that act, too, you can give, during that week, you can give each other what they call deep kisses. This study came out of Rutgers. A professor there established that there are three types of kisses. As we get more acquainted, we give a kiss to signal deep feelings, right? It's sort of like a tertiary kiss, right? It lets you know, hey, you're on your way. There's another kiss reserved to express romantic love that you and each other have booed up.
Right.
Now, given credit for that term, we caught that term about maybe 3-4 years ago, Cheryl Lee Ralph,
mm-hmm.
if I'm not mistaken, used that. So
right.
I give credit to Cheryl.
So remember, all of this kissing is part of foreplay. So that foreplay is very important.
I got a great follow-up answer for that. In fact, the most intimate kiss actually opens the door for foreplay and triggers the sex drive, right? That's the third type kiss that she said is the most magnanimous, right? It actually invites the other into the sex act because it has massive amounts of testosterone that travels in the saliva and in the glands of her cheeks. She's got specific channels, if you will,
right.
that take that directly to the brain. So they take that testosterone, absorb it in her cheeks, and those excited nerve endings go directly to the pleasure centers of the brain.
A lot of times you don't think about when you're kissing somebody and how many nerves and everything else that you excite just by kissing. And so that deep kissing and that passionate kissing triggers a lot, and it triggers that testosterone, not so much in the man, all right, but it involves the testosterone going through each of your bodies.
Right. They say that's why men have a tendency to want or favor sloppy kisses.
Right.
Because
right.
all that testosterone is mixed
right.
with all that saliva.
Uh-huh. And wet kisses. Really wet kisses.
So we've been talking more or less, but we don't want to leave anything out. So we've been talking about.
Now listening to Our Two Cents FYC show with Jose and Tinsley Brooks on Jammin' 107 WJAM. Music that makes you jam.
What I've been missing always.
Listening to Our Two Cents FYC show with Jose and Tinsley Brooks on Jammin' 107 WJAM. Music that makes you jam.
A couple of times, or maybe more times.
Now, Tinsley mentioned a couple of fingers, and indeed, if you've been keeping up with current events, they're, their Facebook posting going back and forth about the back door, okay? And it has to do with two fingers. We're not going to suggest whether you use two fingers or a whole fist, right? Just be careful to use plenty of lubricant.
Mm-hmm.
They make a, so as you explore each other's back door, right, be sure to use plenty of lubricant. Don't just decide today also. Remember, communication is key.
Right.
Don't, you know, come home with the attitude, I'm going to ram this thing you know,
thank
you,
ma'am.
And you're going to like it.
I
talk about it,
ma'am.
It's really slow and easy. Start with a small finger massage outside. Advance maybe to the soft tongue and work around that outside before you ever go into the inside.
And remember now, all of this stuff is good for you and everything else. Remember, and remember that your home, your room is private to you. So you can just explore just about everything.
All right. So now you want to be careful when you introduce other objects into the bedroom. So, like this. That new thing, I bought that offline.
No.
It talks about, you know, you can put this, this literally suctions our bodies together. Makes
right.
for a more intimate.
And more sticks intimate. You together.
Right. So what do you think about that?
So, I don't know. We never talked about this. Wait. Right. We never talked about this, okay?
All
right. That's like a dust bag. Is that a dust bag?
I don't
at
know.
The
I
end
just
of that thing?
I maybe need to study this.
You need to
structure.
Study that, okay? So
right.
we'll come back to you on that,
okay?
Right?
So we'll talk about that some more.
Yeah,
maybe
we have to talk.
Watch.
We got to communicate on that, okay?
Maybe we just watch some porn together.
Right.
That might give us some ideas on how to stimulate conversation. In fact, couples out there, don't overlook porn either and the importance of it to enhance, give that bedroom some extra spice. They do have a lot of tips on there.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure they do. Oh, there.
So you can flex it up at times, right? At times going for fast and passionate. Some and then, you know, pick spots for a quickie, and other times go long and slow. And I think they call that the slow hand.
Yes, yeah, slow hand is much better, all right? And like I used to tell Jose, don't rush it, baby. I'm not going nowhere.
Right.
I'm still right here.
She's right there.
I'm right here.
Yeah.
So we'll be okay.
I take instruction pretty good.
Yes, you do.
All right.
That's now, why we're still here together.
There you go. Now, we can send... sexy text to each other. Why don't you tell
me? Oh, yeah. Sexy text is good.
You have an ideal.
Sexy text is good. I use it when I go to the hairdresser. When I go to the hairdresser, that's when I take time to do my sex texting. I'm under the dryer, and I might be under the dryer 30 to 45 minutes. So I got a lot of time to sex text my boy. Okay?
Yeah. And I, you know, sex text in the back, and in fact, those hairdresser appointments are actually, hey, a good thing we use.
Mm-hmm.
It's an inside joke. It's not very graphic, right? But it's an inside joke. That she runs back and tells her stylist, hey, my hairstyle didn't last past the week, you know, because I get in that hair.
Right, and right. He knows that too.
All right, so treat each other in the way of spicing things up, right, and enhance your communications together. Treat each other to a surprise lunch. right, every now and then, and make it a real surprise.
Right, every now and then. Or even, and just like I do, sometimes I might come home for lunch. If I'm close, and if you're close, if you come home for lunch or you're able to get to your partner for lunch and surprise them.
But the operative word, I'll be a little naughty, is come.
Right.
All right. Let's move on. Get loud or silent now and then. Play games together where the winning prize is a quickie. And sometimes I charge you for all the little things I have to do around the house.
Right.
Prepare this, fix that.
Right.
I tell you.
And then when he's good around the house and he helps out with this, helps out with that, or he drops me off at the store and he drops me off at the door, and I say, coupon.
There you go.
Hey.
You guys know what that is.
So that those coupons add up.
Right.
Okay.
Speaking of added up, you can amp up your floor plan, and if you just remember that it begins the morning of, not 5 minutes prior to. So amp up that foreplay and have a good time. Speaking of good time, you can practice.
Oh. Right, going down.
Hey, going down should help you both get up, if you know what we mean. All right? Become excellent lovers for each other. You should be intending fellas to curl her toes and ladies...
pull his toes.
There you go.
All right? And by pulling his toes, you can look at his toes and look at them and see them wiggling. All right?
That's when you know, hey, you're getting to him. You're getting into his head. Partner punch.
Y'all should see the smile on his face, when you talk about pulling his toes. All right.
This next area has to do with sex toys, and we just want to make one thing clear, and that is that two important items in before you get into sex toys. Number one, and in fact, most, if you go to a store or pick it up, that agent behind the counter will tell you or recommend some kind of cleaning, something to make that object sterile, right? So you're looking at the cleaning and lubrication, right? You don't want to insert anything into the bedroom that you're not fully trained on, and you don't want to insert anything in each other's bodies that isn't sterile and that body isn't, you know, well lubricated to receive it.
But you're always thinking about health.
But what kind of toys do you know that they got out there?
Well, the toys, you know, a lot of toys vibrate, stimulate, and simulate and motivate.
They got toys that make you late, make you shake,
make your body quake.
They got toys that buzz, that ring, that ding, that ping.
They have toys too that make probe and strobe. Toys that silver and quiver.
Right.
Everything else in between.
There you go.
They have all types of toys.
And remember, before you get into a toy, you want to make sure that it's sterile.
And
you got some lubrication, all right? If you both enjoy it, the whole thing with toys, if you both enjoy it, then it ain't necessarily freaky.
If it is, get
your freak on.
Right.
Plan exciting trips together, where lovemaking is always the destination.
Oh, yeah. There you go. I like that.
All right, cool. In the next couple of days over to Florida.
Right.
For some golf and Tinsley for some shopping.
Shopping.
Got to get out of this winter weather in Chicago. Man.
Right. All right. Another thing is listening to mood music, okay?
You
I like Maxwell.
Say that three times.
Mood
really
music.
You go, girl.
I like Maxwell. All right.
And Barry White. And
Barry White.
If you're really up on things, right, our first novel in the player line has a reflection of Barry White's music. You know, we didn't have the music there in the words, but
mm-hmm.
it talks about the music and how the hero of the story, Theo, is using music on one of his girlfriends.
Right. Another thing is make sure that you experiment with some mood candles.
Lights out in the room,
lights.
Music on low, romantic
right.
music on low, and, you know, you got these mood candles that are different colors, flickering, not flickering,
mm-hmm.
and really spice things up.
Some flowers. Maybe even your old flowers, you know, after they go, you know, past a few days. Take the petals off. Put the petals on the bed, okay?
We're not going to give this next gentleman unearned advertising, but one of the more fantastic times you had is on our anniversary.
Right.
We went to a real fancy, what you might call 5-star hotel.
Right.
Downtown Chicago. And Tinsley claims
Hey, I had the best
guest. The best time of her life. They had rose petals on the bed, and on the carpet leading up to the bed, they had like a fruit dish. There was lighted mirrors in the bathroom that had TV on it.
The best thing is, after that experience we had, and in the bed with the rose petals and everything else, I looked out the window and they had
help me.
Right. You know, like New Year's Eve or 4th of July, they had the street lights and everything else. And when you saw that, you saw all the sparkles and everything else.
She's reflecting back, ladies and gentlemen. We're popping. Let's move on.
So those sparkles, you know, kind of help that orgasm.
Take a warm bath together, right? in that tub or warm shower together.
Right.
And communicate only using touch and feel. Send, you know, signals to each other.
Right.
Right. Have a little language. In fact, you might want to kind of test it out and you know, write down what you intended to say, right, that you were trying to say just with your touch and your feel together.
So that spices up a lot. It spices up a lot. And sometimes, too, you know, you don't always have to have sex. You can just...
Huh?
Just look at each other, communicate with each other, and you might have to just hold each other for the night.
There you go.
Okay.
Or just caress.
Right.
Hold and caress. Like, we'll tell you the difference maybe in another episode.
Right.
The couples out there that are full-fledged know the distinction.
Right. So, okay. So, invest in a getaway playhouse or spend the weekend in a fancy hotel.
Like we've been talking
about. Right. Just go on and get away. You know, it doesn't have to be, and sometimes it don't have to be at a hotel. Maybe you want to go out to the park and just walk the park, you know, for a Saturday and bring a basket of lunch.
Making love, when you're both really tired, actually you'll find that will really re-energize you both and your relationship. So maybe give that a try.
Next time
you're painting the house, right? Tilly's a fantastic painter, too. Next time you're painting the house together, knocking out a room or two, hey, and you're really tired, hey, sex, making love, that could be the answer. Use this winter to your relationship, right, to the advantage of your relationship. If you live in a cold climate like us, you can read our novel, The Player Line, or anyone in that series of three, soon to be four books, has some incredible sex scenes in there to give you ideas. In fact, there are great authors, Eric Jerome Dickey and Zane. We met Eric. We need
right.
to meet Zane.
Right.
They're gifted at exciting your inner sexiness. You can increase your frequency, too. The national average is?
Yeah, the national average is 1 to 2 times a month.
Right. It's actually 1.2.
I'm sorry.
What that 0.2 is. I guess
a month.
I'm close, but you don't round first base. Many of you out there are like us, right? You're well above and beyond that ratio. Right. Always find a reason to laugh.
You're
doing a lot of that, right?
Right?
Even if it's at yourself. Every day, you should look for ways to make each other laugh and smile.
And that's a good thing. You want to make sure, ladies and gentlemen, our 2 cents makes you laugh, all right? And keep tuned to us.
Yeah. We would appreciate that you write us and let us know your opinions on the show. And, hey, we'll give you a penny for those thoughts. Be sure to write us with your comments at our2cents@aol.com. So that's
right.
O-U-R, the number 2, C-E-N-T-S, at AOL.com.
That's a penny for your thoughts.
There you go. Now, our quiz for the next session is, it's going to shock you, right? But have they been teaching us biology wrong? Well, not biology. What would you call it? Medical? Anatomy.
Anatomy.
Do females, here's your question, right? Do females have a penis? That's our question. Something to think about. Communicate to us, and we'll see you coming up.
All right. Remember now, we're at our2cents@AOL.com.
All right. So let's test this thing.
No, Jose, we don't need to test that.
All right. Well, we'll talk about it. See you, ladies and gents. Bye-bye.
Take care.
for fun.